This is a little video about Commodores and their coats. This is a two-year-old. This is Trixie. So her coat is fully developed. You can see all the cords. They mostly take care of themselves. Sometimes you have to split them. Not too much. She's missing a few on her back where Buddy likes to pull them out. This is Buddy's coat. It's quite similar, but Buddy's self-corded, which means it was already formed into cords as a puppy, whereas Trixie's had to be separated into individual cords. And this is Angel. She's 11 months old, so she's still got a puppy coat. But as you can see on the back of the neck, it's starting to mat together. Look, there's the start of a cord coming up. It usually starts behind the ears and on the neck, so you can see these clumps coming up. And other places on the legs sometimes you'll see cords coming up, and around the back here, so you can see she's like Trixie again, so her cords will need splitting into individual cords, but just trying to keep them the right sort of width. On her back and starting to cord up along her back, but still got that puppy fluff all over the place. And then around the ears, there's a few cords developing around her face. But it's just getting her used to being groomed, and she likes it. She wants me to do it all the time. And this is tricks again. So yeah, when they're at this stage, all you have to do is pull the cords apart a little bit every now and again, but they take care of themselves really. The feet can get quite messy, so you probably want to trim them a little bit. Keep the pads nice and short so they don't get grass seed and mud and stuff attached. On the muzzle as well, that can get quite dirty, and if it stays wet, then it can start to smell quite horrible. So we trim ours a little bit just to keep them nice and clean. Hello Trixie, how's it going? And you have to clean out the ears as well, if you can find them. So that's sort of 2 years growth there. They say about 3 or 4 inches a year. Here comes Buddy. He wants to be in on the action. An Angel here. Yeah, so Buddy's a bit thinner cords than Trixie's really, but some of his are sort of combining together into bigger cords. Every so often you'll see that. And you can either split them if you don't want them to combine. Here's a good example. So that used to be two cords and now it's one cord because it joined up together. So that one's good because I want to keep them a bit thicker. But you know, if they're too thick, then you want to split them down, obviously. Hello, Angel. You alright? Also, you'll find, obviously, around the boys, around this area, we'll get quite a lot of staining. So that will need extra cleaning, as you can see there. And on girls, obviously, around the back is where it gets dirty. So that's about it really. That's cords. The other thing, if you look close at the cords, you'll see They don't actually mat all the way to the skin. So this bit is, this bit at the bottom of the cord is all free. It doesn't mat up until about, you're about half an inch out or so. So the skin is nice and free, and I mean, on Angel, the clumpy stuff, it, you know, you have to split that and make sure it's free and easy, able to breathe. Oh, hi Trix, do you want some attention? This is Trix, she's in charge. In charge of the dogs anyway, not in charge of me. Angel. Hello, Trix.